Please join me in welcoming our Secretary of State, Condoleezza Rice.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Paula, for that kind introduction, and thank you very much for everything that you do every day to advance this cause. It's with a great pleasure that I'm here today, and I would like to recognize the many dignitaries and honored guests who have joined us. I see several members of the Diplomatic Corps. Thank you for joining us, and several of our friends from the private sector, non-governmental organizations, and corporate sector. Thank you. I'm honored to join you as we celebrate this year's International Women's Day. The day is an opportunity to highlight a broad range of issues of common concern to all women, regardless of their race, creed, or nationality. It is a time to reflect on past accomplishments, to recognize current reform efforts that are underway, and to acknowledge the challenges that still lie ahead. Last year, we at the State Department established the Secretary's International Women of Courage Award. This is an opportunity to pay tribute to women from around the world who courageously champion equal rights in their communities and whose personal sacrifice is an inspiration to all who seek peaceful change. President Bush has said that the struggle for women's rights is a story of strong women willing to take the lead. The eight women who we honor today are the living embodiment of that fact. From Somalia and Fiji to Iraq and Afghanistan, from Pakistan and Paraguay to Kosovo and the Palestinian territories, these women of courage are transforming their societies from the bottom up, and in doing so, they are inspiring us all. Our eight honorees are among 95 exceptional women who were nominated by American embassies worldwide. Despite differences of language, ethnicity, and background, these eight women share a commitment to the non-negotiable demands of human dignity, the conviction that no culture, no religion, and no tradition of any nation provides license for treating women as objects or instruments to be commanded by another. In too many parts of the world, unfortunately, women still struggle for basic rights and liberties in places where discrimination and exploitation and violence against women is all too common and all too often accepted or tolerated. In too many parts of the world, women still do not share equal rights with men or have access to justice. Despite seemingly insurmountable challenges, and often at great risk to their own lives, today's honorees have made a conscious decision to remain committed to the cause of equal justice for women. These heroines also represent so many other women around the world who fight and sacrifice so that future generations may benefit from human rights protections, access to justice and democracy, and greater prosperity and personal security in their countries. These eight women of courage may not be as well known as other brave women, such as Aung San Suu Kyi, who remains under house arrest, or women like Benazir Bhutto, who lost her life working for democracy. But these iconic leaders, like these iconic leaders, the women who we honor today are an inspiration to women in their own countries and around the world who are working for freedom and positive change. And I may say, too, that they represent not just women in their courage, but all people who seek equal justice, equal rights, and the non-negotiable demands of human dignity. And they are an inspiration to me. The United States remains deeply committed to helping women of courage everywhere to peacefully remove the barriers to political, economic, and social empowerment for themselves and for others. This is a calling that requires dedication, commitment, and passion. And to our honorees here today, and to women around the world who are watching today's events, I say this to each and every one of you. In your quest for justice and dignity, know that you will always have a friend and a partner in the United States of America. The United States looks forward to working with all of you, our world's true women of courage. Congratulations on your accomplishments. Can everybody ask? Good. Thank you again.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.